Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. On this video, I'll tell you about what is Kaboma 940 in full details in terms of its composition, properties, uses and Kaboma ratio in terms of the amount of Kaboma that you need to use into a mixture. We've been receiving emails on people asking about how can you produce gel into a mixture, or simply and shortly, what makes the hand sanitizer to become a gel. Okay, the answer to that question is the responsible ingredient that makes your hand sanitizer to become a gel is actually the Kaboma 940. As I said, how is this video going to be structured? I'll tell you about its composition, properties, uses and Kaboma ratio in terms of the amount of Kaboma that you need to use into a certain mixture. If you're stopping by the channel for the first time, make sure that you subscribe. Smash that like button for me. Also consider dropping us a comment below. Okay, here we go. Let's start by talking of the composition of Kaboma 940. You need to know that it's a high molecular weight polymer of polyacrylic acid, okay? That is its chemical composition. Now, in terms of properties, let's talk of the properties. Properties, okay? It has many properties. Let at least take two of them, physical properties, okay? The first one, it's a white powder in terms of appearance. Okay, and one more particular thing, it produces high viscosity while dissolved into a liquid. The next point, let us talk of the uses. What is it used for? Okay, it's actually used to produce or make a gel. So we're going to say gelling agent. That's it. Okay, then the next point, I'll tell you about the Kaboma ratio. Okay, how much amount of Kaboma do you use into a mixture? Kaboma ratio, let's say in water or ethanol. Okay. How much Kaboma do you need to dissolve? You need to know that the amount of Kaboma should be of 0.2%, 0.5%, even up to 1% of the total volume, okay? Let me write this down, then there's something particular that I'm going to explain, okay? So amount of Kaboma should be of 0.2%, okay, or 0.5%. Some people even go up to 1% of the total volume. Okay, let me frame this, and there's something that I'm going to explain. Okay, as I was saying, that you can use 0.2%, okay, it's all up to you. You can use 0.5% or even up to 1%. The difference here, it will all depend on how thick you want your gel to be. Okay, if you just want a light gel, you can consider 0.2% of the total volume. If you want a medium gel, you can consider 0.5% of the total volume. Okay, then if you wish to obtain a heavy gel, you can even go up to 1% of the total volume. Okay, that's it. And you need to know that naturally Kaboma is acidic. Okay, so while mixing it, you need to consider raising up the pH. Okay, and while you raise up the pH, you'll notice that your mixture or your gel has actually become transparent. Then you can stop. Okay, you can actually do this gradually. That's it. Thank you guys for watching. Make sure that you subscribe to the channel. As I always say, that there is a lot to learn from here. Make sure that you like our videos, share them, and also suggest the channel. to people you know with the interest of learning. Thank you guys for watching. Make sure that you subscribe and see you on the next video.